Hey Leo, this is going to be a 72&U reading, our next 72 reading for the Leo Collective. So you can watch this reading if you are Leo Sun, Moon, Rising, Leo on the house cusp. If you have your Sun in the fifth house or Venus in Leo, feel free to watch this reading. I'm debating whether or not I want to turn the ring light or the ring light on today. Let's see. Okay, that's fine. We can leave it on. Let's see here. Okay. All right. Leo. What's going on with you, Leo? So, personal reading information down below in that description box, including my website and scheduling page. Just click the eye in the sky. That will take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. I'm just trying to light some sage here to clear any negative energy out. So once again, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please come get a personal private tarot reading from either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. Give me one second, guys, because I have gotten some smudge on the table. So, I wanted to do your reading today. I went to choose the Wizard's Tarot deck out of my tarot reading room, and I chose what I thought was the Wizard's Tarot, but it ended up being the Starman Tarot. So I said, okay, it is Aquarius season, so that's fine. We can just read with the Starman Tarot today. Then I was like, oh, maybe I should do a whatever comes out reading, but I think I just did a couple of those. And I was like, oh, well, maybe I'll pick out of the cauldron here. And I was like, no. I'll just do a Leo reading. So, no promises, guys. I read the cards how they come out. I'm very honest about what I see. So, take my readings with a grain of salt. All right. What I just sprayed is an aromatherapy spray for stress relief. It contains eucalyptus and spearmint. It's an essential oil mist from the Bath & Body Works, for anyone that's interested in what that is. Okay, I also have this like Palo Santo candle here. It's really nice. So we got our good vibes going here. And also, I still have memberships open. If you would like to join one of my membership levels, I have two membership levels right now. One is my Crazy Leo Gang membership, which is a regular membership level, which starts at $8.99 a month. And the other one is my Platinum level that starts at $99.99 a month. That's the I'm Platinum Bitch level. And you get 72&U readings like this one. You get the ability to watch the reading, play the reading, and comment on the reading for more than 24 hours. So, and also there's other psychic predictions and stuff like that on my channel. Anyways, I'll go ahead and timestamp the reading so you can skip this intro if you want to. Underneath the deck, we do have the Lovers. Some of you could be dealing with themes around your twin. You could have a major decision to make. You could be dealing with a Gemini. Okay, there's definitely something also very sexual with this card in this particular deck. So maybe not just sexual, but like lovemaking, that kind of thing. So I don't know, that could be, maybe you're making love to someone, or it is, I think Valentine's Day is around the corner, if I'm not mistaken. Hopefully no one's getting any breakup pies from Pizza Hut. All right, let's see. Spirit, what do you have for Leo over the next 72 hours? For the Leo Collective, what do you have for my Leos that may be watching? Leo suns, moons, risings. Leo's on the house cusp. Those with their sun in the fifth house and Venus and Leo. Let's give the cards a good shuffle. I can feel the coldness coming from the cards because they were in my tarot room, my office. And it is a bit colder in there, to be honest with you. All right, so shuffling cards with long nails is a whole different ball game. So let's see. Leo, what do you have for the Leo Collective? Probably gonna do about 10 cards today. Let's see. Leo, are you with me? We have the Four of Pentacles in reverse. That's Capricorn's energy. Let's get a couple more here. What's going on with Leo over the next 72 hours? Some of you are opening up about something. Okay, this is kind of my opening the vault energy. Throwing the baby out with the bathwater. which, I don't know about that expression. We have the Three of Cups in reverse. Careful who you open up to. It doesn't look like you have good friends around you or any friends right now. You could be dealing with loneliness in your community, groups of friends here, people gossiping behind your back, slandering you or talking about you behind your back. You could be dealing with, people that aren't your friends. So maybe frenemies. What's going on with Leo over the next 72 hours? Someone is doing something with foil. Okay, you could be putting your hair in foil or, I don't know, maybe getting highlights or something like that, or doing some sort of hair treatment, or, I don't know, just seeing something with like aluminum foil here, foil wrap. What's going on with Leo over the next 72 hours, please? We have the Prince of Cups. Could be dealing with a younger water sign or a child here. I'm seeing a male child or a very immature young man. This is like, doesn't have to be a water sign, just a very immature younger masculine energy is coming up here. You could be receiving a message from this person or communicating with them. We have Temperance in reverse, Sagittarius. And the Prince of Pentacles in reverse. So there's something here that there's no consensus on. It also feels like you're agitated by something here. I feel like your normal spiritual protection, your guardian angels and ancestors, they're still around you, but I feel like you either need to up your protection or one of your main spirit guides, one of your main angels is... I feel like, I hate to say it, but I feel like they are kind of stepping out on you, Leo. I feel like they're kind of like saying, like, in your current environment or your current situation, you have less protection than you think. Prince of Pentacles is in reverse. Someone could be dealing with a younger masculine energy here that's very unchivalrous, or this is you. I'm seeing someone here that doesn't pick up after themselves, is not focused on their studies. You could be having attention deficit issues, for example, or there's a lack of concentration here on your studies. There's a lack of focus. If you are dealing with a child here, this child could be having a lot of temper issues or agitated by something. It could be a health concern for some people out there. Someone could be having health issues. It's kind of bumpy. It looks kind of rough. I'll be honest with you. Someone could be ignoring someone as well from a communication standpoint or not budgeting, not paying attention to financial matters. It really does feel a little all over the place here and it doesn't really feel very grounded. You could be dealing with a Capricorn, a Cancer, a Pisces, Scorpio, or a Sagittarius. Can I get some more cards for Leo, please, over the next 72 hours? We have the Ace of Pentacles in reverse, the Two of Wands in reverse, and the Hanged Man in reverse. A lot of reversals. So you could be experiencing delays here or in a retrograde of some kind. I don't believe we're in a retrograde. I don't think so. Anyway, after the Prince of Pentacles is in reverse, the Ace of Pentacles reverse can indicate a bounce check, a missed opportunity, or someone is not healthy here. Someone is rejecting something or throwing something out. It feels to me like the seed is not getting planted here because either the environment is not right, the timing is not right, or this is a missed opportunity for someone out there. Someone is then feeling hopeless. This is my Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas card, the Two of Wands reversed, and the Hanged Man in reverse. Someone is a hypocrite. Someone is saying one thing, doing another. This is a lot of hypocrisy here. It's also a lot of procrastination. We're thinking about something, we have a brilliant idea, but we're not ready to release it in the world. And also usually with the Hangman reverse, we've already hung ourselves upside down. So we're just looking at something from another perspective, but that doesn't seem to be helping. I know, Leo, looks like you're not in a great situation here, between a rock and a hard place, if I am to be honest with you, because I am a very honest reader, so I don't sugarcoat shit. I don't sugarcoat shit on here. I just tell it like it is, and, you know, maybe some of you are not going through that, and that's fine, but yeah, that's what I'm seeing. We have the Princess of Pentacles. So again, someone could be doing black magic here. It could be an earth sign, okay, because we have the Prince of Pentacles reversed and the Princess of Pentacles in reverse. That's earth magic as well. So you could be dealing with someone here that is dabbling in the dark arts. If that's not the case, then someone here could have a serious health issue and they're not really taking care of it, or they're not taking care of themselves, or this is someone's child who is sick. It could be a boy and a girl child. Someone could be dealing with physical abuse as well, because I'm seeing someone here has like a black eye or something. I don't know. Be careful, Leo. There could be a younger earth sign that is, or this is this younger earth sign that's dealing with this. Can I get one more card for Leo here? We have the Six of Swords. Okay, that's Aquarius's energy, and that is the second deacon of Aquarius. So I do see you actually exiting this, out of this energy eventually, probably towards the end of the 72-hour period. We have the Ace of Cups. And this could involve you getting, you know, it's good when the Ace of Cups is in the upright position, because this is about unconditional love here and also a blessing coming in. Maybe all of this is to teach you a lesson or to give you a blessing. This seems like maybe a rougher period of your life. It's not going to last forever. It's just the next 72 hours. I don't feel like you're getting a lot of stuff done. I feel like you could be dealing with a sick child or just like grumpiness or agitation. It does feel to me like you are not making maybe much money, or you're losing money, or you're losing an opportunity here. I'm not sure why. You could be dealing with a lot of immature people. Of course, you could be dealing with, there's a lack of attention to detail as well. You have not a good community support system around you. You don't have friends that support you. I mean, so it's kind of one of those chuck it in the F it bucket. A big effort bucket, and then move on, because that's what I'm seeing. So I don't know, like, you can just blame me for this reading. If you don't want to accept responsibility, you don't want to claim this reading, just blame me for the terrible reading. But I mean, it is what it is. I, like I said, I just call like I see it, guys. And, you know, so I tried. All right, Leo, I hope that things get better over the, I hope that they do. I see you moving out of this. I mean, the Six of Swords indicates that you are leaving the troubled waters behind and moving on to something better. So I hope and pray that that's the case for you. And, of course, I send you peace, love, blessings, love, light, all that stuff. take good care of yourself. Thanks for watching.